Okay, well, I want you guys to make some real noise for the dynamic duo that's going to rock the house. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the one, the only, the infamous 20 Penny Circus!
Circus. For those of you guys that do not know who we are, a quick introduction. This is Carl Skeens. Hands down the classiest one-man freak show, but he's also a magician, a contortionist, a balloon artiste. He's an intriguing individual, but grotesque nonetheless.
And this is Tyler Sutter, skilled in the art of magic, juggling, and acts of equilibrium. He's classy, kinda, and he's a consummate show-off. Now, at the 20 Penny Circus, we offer entertainment for people with questionable taste.
And tonight, that looks like all of you. Now, here at the 20 Penny Circus, you will have questions that will not be answered.
Your puzzles will not be solved.
And you will see things you will not believe.
Much like the Holocaust, the moon landing, and economic recovery.
Economic recovery?
Now the magic is mind-blowing and the stunts are real.
But first, we're actually going to need some money. If anybody has a dollar bill that we can borrow, any bill will work. A $1 bill. If you could just hold it up in the air so we can see. Anybody with just a simple one. And he's got it. Oh, right, I'm going to squeeze past everybody. I don't want to knock anybody's beer over. All right, so I'm actually going to give you a receipt for your bill, okay? So he's going to have two parts of the bill. All we need you to do is hold on to this one. Grab onto that. Keep it in your pocket. Keep it in your hand, whatever you would like to do. The rest of the bill, we're going to give it a little fold and a little fold. And I believe this is yours. You're going to hold on to that. He eats everything. That was awkward. Quick change of subject. We're going to need a brave lady.
Oxymoron.
That's not very nice. We're going to use you. If you could watch your step, go right over here. Perfect. And I actually have a chair for you, my dear. If you could take a seat in our chair. Perfect. And what was your name?
April,
nice to meet you. My name is Tyler. This is Carl.
Hello, April. Now, this next bit is more a feat than anything else. It's more a stunt than a trick. In order to perform this stunt, you do need three things. Number one, you need a hammer. Verify this is a real hammer. It doesn't bend, break, or telescope in any way. Fantastic. Secondly, you need a nail.
Volume.
I want you to verify this is a real 20-penny nail. It doesn't bend, break, telescope in any way. It's a regular 6.5-inch nail. You could buy at any Home Depot. Take your time. I wouldn't.
Everything good? 6.5 inches? Your boyfriend's so lying to you. We save my favorite part for last is the part where you get to feel me up. So I'm going to need you to touch my head.
My face. I need you to touch my face. Now, careful of the clown makeup. Just make sure there's no phony skin. Excellent job. You've examined the hammer, you've examined the nail, and you've examined my head. Without any further ado, maestro, please.
need you to hold out your index finger, your thumb for me. You're going to squeeze onto the head of the nail, just the tip. It still counts.
Just the tip. Oh my God.
And once again, the nice little snack you get at the end.
Yeah!
And just for helping out, you get your very own I Nailed a Clown button.
Circus, I would like to give you my sincerest apologies for having to witness that, but now it is my turn, and I have something for you. If you could examine this for me, please, a simple coin. Make sure the coin doesn't bend, break, telescope in any way. It is a regular coin. Now, back in the days of the old sideshow, there was this one gentleman, the human ostrich. He would open the show every night by borrowing coins, one by one from the audience, and he would eat every single coin. At the end of the show, he would return with a silver platter, and just as he ate the coin, he would regurgitate them one by one. And that's how he made his money. Because, of course, nobody wanted it back. So we're going to try that, but take it one step further.
I'm just to fill a dream on my imagination. Time for a kiss. Sweetheart, I ask no more than this.
Do me a favor. Hold on to these. Perfect. Here we go. Hold out your hand.
Give me a kiss before you leave. Why aren't you listening? My hungry heart. Keep me. I think I need one. I
found my
dream. Oh, boy. Look at that.
I almost got it.
It's almost there.
Oh, it's up there. Oh, you see him? Well, tell me where it is. You want to get it? Maybe there's a smaller tool on this. Knife? No. You got a smaller one? Here, I'll trade you. Here we go. These look like they're on the autopsy table inside, but... Oh yeah, there it is. Go ahead and hold on to that for me. Grab tight. Okay, now this is my nostril. I'm totally going to be using this later. Careful. There it is. Go ahead and look at that quarter. Make sure that was the one you checked out earlier. And a souvenir for you, my dear. You can keep that. Give her a huge round of applause for helping out. And you can go back to your seat. Now we brought a special guest for you guys. That involves the mind and what it is capable of. Mankind has always been fascinated with the mind, what it can do, what it is capable of, and exactly how dirty it can be. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Naked Mentalist.
See this? Oh, sorry. That was last night's show. You guys wouldn't want to see that. Would you?
Oh, no.
No, you know, never mind. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, I am the Naked Mentalist, and tonight I am here to fuck with your minds. But first, I wanted to tell you guys a little something. This is an important fact I think everybody here should know. Ladies and gentlemen, approximately 90 to 100% of all babies born in America are annoyed by that sound right now. I'm kidding, but seriously, 90 to 100% of all babies born in America are born naked. It's true. Yes. Naked. All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, another interesting statistic is that approximately 50% of all people believe that they have some sort of psychic and or intuitive ability. And as the naked mentalist, I've actually caused all the power to go out right now. And I'm going to keep this show going because I am one loud motherfucker. All right, are we back in business? Yes, that sounds perfect. Like I was saying, the psychic test. Excuse me, miss in the front row on your phone, texting someone else who's not here, who's not me, who I don't care about. You act as if you see this every day. I have a question for you. What's your name?
Donnell.
Donnell, the naked mentalist. Yes, Donnell. Slap skins. Very nice. Donnell, do you believe that you have any psychic and or intuitive ability? All right, well, I've actually developed a test, and I'd like you to take it, okay? And this is how we're going to find out whether or not you're psychic, okay? All you need to do is read through the numbers in a nice, clear, loud voice. And if any of them stand out to you or jump out in any way, just please let me know. This is how we'll determine whether or not you have any of this ability, okay? So begin. Oh, no, it's okay. The numbers, not my face. Oh, it's all right. It's all right. Go for it. No, a little slower, please. It's okay. I'm sorry if I scared you. But see, that's how we figure out whether or not she's psychic. Because if she was, she would have seen that coming. You were perfect. Thank you very much. Matter of fact, actually, while we did that, I seemed to feel a little bit of a connection with you. Actually, would you mind if I used you for one more experiment? Everybody, give Donnell a big round of applause for being here. Thank you so much. If you do me a favor, have a seat right here, Donnell. Was this over here? All right, ladies and gentlemen, I am now going to take off my robe. Please hold your applause. You may applaud. All right, Donnell, you and I are going to try one of my favorite experiments in mind-to-mind communication. But first, we need something for you to focus on. And luckily, I happen to have the perfect thing. Oh yeah, it's that kind of show. All right, give me a second, guys. This can take a minute. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, flashcards. The perfect thing to focus on. Sir, you seem a little disappointed. Here we have a stack of about 40 different flashcards, each one with a different common everyday activity. These are all things you could do, and you could do naked. For instance, you could read, you could jump, you could paint, you could cry, and so on and so on. All I need you to do is say stop as I go through the activities. Here we go. Quick, do me a favor, Donnell, take that activity there. Don't show it to anyone, but take a look at it yourself. Now, is that an activity you're familiar with? Yes, great. Do me a favor. Take the card, don't show it to anyone, but hold it face down against your chest and give it a squeeze. That is one very happy card right now. All right, Donnell, concentrate on your activity because I am now going to read your mind. Here we go. Everyone, total silence, please. Interesting. Donnell, is there an E in the activity you're thinking of? I thought so. Look at me. Speak to me with those eyes. Yes, they say a lot. All right, that helps me narrow it down. The activity you're concentrating on, is it something you get some enjoyment from? Yes, I thought so. Do me a favor, close your eyes. I don't want anyone to see my prediction that I've made, but I believe this is what Donnell is thinking of right now, ladies and gentlemen. All right, this activity you're concentrating on, is it the kind of thing you do on a weekly or a daily basis? Yes. Multiple times a day? I thought so. Very nice. Have you ever done it in public? Nice. Who do you normally do this activity with? You know some very lucky people then. I hesitate to ask, but have you ever done this in a car? Front or back seat? both. Nice. Here, hold on. Let me move the mic a little bit closer to you. I hesitate to ask, but have you ever done this on a plane?
Yes.
Very nice. First class all the way, I'm sure. This activity you're thinking of, is it something you would ever do with me?
Sure.
I'm willing to pay, just so you know. One last question, and please be honest. What is the main part of your body you use for the activity you're concentrating on? Your mouth, nice, yes. For the first time, in a nice, clear, loud voice, into the microphone, please tell everyone here the activity you're thinking of.
Eating.
All right, this is awkward. But make some noise, because that's exactly what I was thinking. Danelle, thank you so much. I actually happen to have a little something for you, Danelle, for being such a good sport and helping out. If you could do me a favor, take your right hand and go like this. Make a fist, close your eyes. Just for 1 second, hold on, Danelle. Yes, there you go. It's an official Naked Mentalist slap bracelet, as worn by me. Thank you so much for letting me play with you. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Danelle. Yeah! Well, thank you guys so much for coming out. I could have been naked in front of anybody in the world here tonight, but I'm really glad it was you here at Abnormality. I'm the Naked Mentalist. Good night.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the clowns have arrived. Once again, I was pausing for the feedback, not for applause, but it's okay. Here at the 20 Penny Circus, we believe in recycling.
We also love beer.
Now, we developed this next act in college.
My own college.
It's a real job. So to combine two of our great passions of beer and recycling, and after some experimentation, we found that my friend Carl likes to play in glass.
Oh, no. You ready?
Do a backflip. That was his, I can't do a backflip. All right, let's have you miss up front. Do me a favor, name any number you would like between 1 and 10. One. I'm on her side. Two. Come on, count with us. Three. Four. Five. One more. That means he likes you. Actually, do me a favor, go ahead and stand up, come up here, give her a huge round of applause. And come right over here for me. You're wearing shoes, right? Our insurance policy doesn't cover spectators in glass. Carl's gonna go ahead and get into position, and I need you to remember one thing, the spot right above your ear and right below. Now, Carl always needs a little coaxing to get into position, so I need each and every one of you, as loud as you can, yell, get your ass in the glass. One, two, three.
Get your ass in the glass!
And those are results. We do not argue with results. So Carl's going to get into position. Remember the spot right above his ear and right below. Now, as soon as you are all the way up, they will break out into a thunderous applause. And that's your cue to take one step off of his face. Are you ready? Here we go. Now the left foot up here. And the right foot goes right below his ear. And the next one goes right above. You got a good view from there, Carl. And you can take one step back. Give her a huge round of applause for helping out. Thank you so much. And Carl lies motionless. And you can go back to your seat. Thank you so much. Are you alive? All right, now the next thing we're going to do is probably the most death-defying thing. I don't know if you guys are familiar with the idea of Russian roulette. It's done with one gun with six chambers, but only one bullet.
a 1 out of 6 chance. Unfortunately, the permitting for a loaded gun in a venue like this is illegal, so we had to go to the next best thing. We're going to do our Russian roulette with these 4 18-gauge pneumatic brad nailers. Now, these three guns that Carl has don't matter. This is the one gun that does. The one gun that's loaded with inch and a half staples, inch and a half nails being loaded into the gun. Now we're going to shoot out of the gun at over 110 PSI.
You missed it.
When I hit it. So we're going to need somebody from the audience. Yes, you missed your permit for this. If you could come up here, give her a huge round of applause. And I need you to remember this one right here, the loaded gun. Now what we're going to have you do is stand right behind this and go ahead and give the guns a quick mix. Yep. Now the idea is for me, for Carl, for her, for everybody in the audience, and everybody on stage to lose track of that one loaded gun. But I'm sure you know where it is, right? She's still shuffling. Go ahead and mix them up a bit. Perfect. Place that one in its spot. I'm going to go ahead and give him a quick mix myself. If you could do me a favor, go ahead and stand right here. Perfect. I'm going to mix them real fast. She looks away and she's lost. Perfect. If you do me one more favor, go ahead and give him a quick mix. One more time. One more time. Mix them up. Perfect. And if you could do me a favor, stand right here. Now here's what's going to happen. We're going to give every single gun a number. And it's simple. 1, 2, 3, and 4. In a moment, you will choose a number. The number you choose is the gun we use. So go ahead, your first choice, 1, 2, 3, or 4.
2.
Gun number 2. And this one gets placed against his hand. One gun down. Go ahead, choose another number. 1, 2, or 4?
4.
Gun number 4. And this one gets placed against his neck. Go ahead, last number. 50-50 chance. Carl's fate rests in your last choice. Gun number 1 or gun number 2?
4.
Gun number 1. And this one gets placed against his temple. Oh, shit. Leaving the last gun, the final gun, the only gun that you did not choose is the one gun locked and loaded with the nails. Give her a huge round of applause for keeping Carl alive. Just a stand.
Alright. I think
you
did it. I don't know if I saw
it. No. Alright, no? On a microphone?
Yeah.
Excellent. Alright. By a show of hands, who here's heard of Harry Houdini?
You!
Excellent. Harry Houdini was the world's most famous escape artist. He can escape.
Wait. Before we get to that, we're about to wrap it up. So before we get to that, let's do this. Once again, we are the 20 Penny Circus. If you like what we do, if you like what you see, check us out on Facebook, 20pennycircus.com, Facebook.com/20pennycircus. Like us, love us, share us, tag us. But by the way, this is our big finish.
All right, and I was saying before I was rudely impregnated.
Interrupted.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Harry Houdini was the world's most famous escape artist. He could escape from anything, handcuffs, chains, rope, anything, and he could even do it naked. Now tonight, we're going to do two of Harry Houdini's most famous other escapes. Tyler's going to be tied to a chair with 100 feet of rope, and I will be placed in a vintage 1976 regulation straight jacket. Now, to do this, we are going to need the help of a couple guys. You got this?
Big, young, strong, strapping men. You, sir! You, sir! You, sir! And you, sir, in the back! Go ahead, come on up here! Give them a huge round of applause for helping out! All right, now here's what's going to happen. I'm going to take you two guys, and where's the other two guys at? There you are. You get to have Carl in the straitjacket. Where's the other guy? Where's the other guy? Where's the other guy? Here, hold on to this for me. Sweet. You can have him. I'm going to need you guys. Here's what's going to happen. We have 100 feet of rope, and we have this chair. So hold on to all of this. I'm going to go ahead and make the first knot for you to make it easy. And all you need to do is wrap me up, tie me up as best as you can. You only have a couple minutes to do it, so go as quick as you can. You can wrap it around the back. Whatever you do, don't let all that rope go, because it'll make a big mess. It'll be really hard to get out. There we go. Perfect. And you made a big mess. It's all right. Try and keep it clean. You want to get me in here so I do not get out. That is the point. You guys have never done this before. What are you, not Boy Scouts? All right. Oh, I'm your first. It's his first. I'm glad I can pop your tying somebody to a chair. Cherry. That's great. You never tied a clown to a chair before? Sorry. It does show. You look like a strong guy. You got another? Sailor? You know any good knots? No. Nothing. Kill my mic a little bit. Halfway.
Thank you very much.
Halfway. How are you doing, Carl? These guys are sucking.
Yeah, dude. Can you, last but not least, we've got two hands.
Oh, no. You don't worry about me. You're trying to tie me up so I don't get out. We've all been drinking a lot. How many of you guys are going to the after party? We handed out 1,000 free shots right here at the venue. So if you have several of those cards, any card that says 20 pennies, show at 9 o'clock, those are redeemable for a free shot at the Benz, which is on...
It's on 1st and 9th.
Talk to those girls. They know where it's at.
Hell yeah. The official Abnormality after party at the Bins on 1st and 9th.
You almost done there?
Be there. Really, it's
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
Right. Hey, are you guys done?
Yeah, they're good. Hey, give them a round of applause for helping out.
All right, once again, we did not mention before, this is a competition. So, you don't have to time us. Obviously, we're competing against each other. If you are on Team Clown Tyler, go ahead and cheer for him. If you're on my team, go ahead and cheer for me.
The louder you are, the more brutal we will be.
Hell yeah. Hey, can we get some escape music? My name is Tyler Sutter. This is Carl Skeens.
Whoa. For one, you got that wrong. My name is Tyler Sutter. You are Carl Skeens, but we are not done yet. If you guys remember at the very beginning of the show, we borrowed a bill, right?
Yeah!
Where's that gentleman at? Go ahead and come up here. Stand right here in the center for me, please. And there's been a box at the front of the stage the entire time. And inside this box... Open that up.
Dollar bill?
And inside of the box, there are five objects. What are they?
Four buttons and a condom.
Four buttons and a condom. One of these things just doesn't belong here. All right, I'm going to grab just the condom. And if you notice, inside of the condom,
there's a condom. Dollar bill.
No, I don't want to touch anything. I want to be as hands-free as I can. So go ahead, pull out that condom, grab the dollar bill as well. Make sure that doesn't fall, and it's a little looped up. So if you could do me a favor, and go ahead and open up. I'll take the condom. You keep the bill. Go ahead and open that up. And go ahead and open up your piece as well. Every single dollar bill that get us serial numbers. I'll take the piece you've been holding on to. You keep the looped up one. I'm going to read off the serial numbers in a loud, clear voice. You tell me if it's correct. L9451638 8D. Does your bill match?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you so much. You can keep that. That's a trick you fixed at home. Once again, my name is Tyler Sutter. This is Carl Skeens. We are the 20 Penny Circus. Find us on Facebook. Check us out at the after party at the Benz. Thank you. Good night. The Naked Metalist.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you could do me a favor, we have a lot of people outside right here, right now. We want to avoid anything, so if you could do me a favor, along the left-hand side of the building, you can also pass, enter back.